I was almost 7 years old when I started going to a Japanese school. They forced us to go to school. To me, I consider it a crash school because they want us to speak Japanese overnight. Now we're on our way to Menengun, concentration camp for majority of Chamorro.
All the way.
Okay. The only reason why I brought you up here because when we mentioned Menengun, I want you to picture the place that you were here, okay? And we were forced labor to Menengun camp from us, from Jonya. We were on that side of that river, okay? Most of the people on that side of the river are from Jonya. This is Menengun concentration camp. Now, after the war, when the Marine or military evacuated us from here, we march up towards the hill, towards
Dotnia?
No.
Towards Palenta?
We follow the river, we follow the up towards the southwest of Menengun. On our way up, there's a lot of, quite a few sick people. They wrapped them on a blanket and they were carrying them. Okay. Okay. And then further up, we came across Japanese dead soldiers floating
in the river
on our way up. And we've been drinking water, man, on our way up.
Oh, man.
Oh,
then as we go further up, we met the military patrol. Some of them are Marines, some of them are Australian. Or the man, they're tall and they got suntan because of the...
Just over here?
Of the Chamorro weather. Our daily routine is just, we pray at night, sometimes six rosaries every hour. We have an old lady that every time they hear the bomb drop somewhere on the west side of the island, she starts shaking. So she starts praying. Then
everyone just starts praying.
Right. But one morning, one day early, the Japanese, they have a headquarters there, because when we came, first when they first marched us here, we set up our shack.
Right, we
used bamboo, we used coconut leaves just to shelter us from the weather. Okay.
Yep. This is like them taking you out of your homes and bringing
you
here.
Yeah, they took us out of
home. This is like, just get what you can and just go. Or it was like a rush evacuation or...
Right,
just...
it is, they call it forced evacuation.
So you just, everything...
In fact, we don't even know where the hell we're heading, going.
Just going anywhere.
We're just following the group.
Was there a lot of death and violence during the evacuation, on your way to Menengun?
During the evacuation, I didn't see too many deaths, but I see a lot of beating.
A lot of beating?
And a threatening beheading. That I see, and also a rifle butt hit, somebody getting hit
with the
rifle.
Butt of the gun. Do you feel that the rescuing of the Chamorro people by the Americans during the Japanese occupation was a priority to the U.S. military, or was it just thank God that we survived the war prior, or the bombing prior to them?
I don't think the Americans have in their pocket to save the Chamorro. Maybe back in their
mind
that eventually we will rescue the Chamorro, okay?
Yep.
But their military priority
is to conquer
is
the island.
Conquer the Marianas Island, Guam, because it's only one stepping stone to defeating the Japanese in mainland Japan.
Yes.
Okay. That is their number one priority.
Back in the day, like in 1930s and 40s.
I don't think the American will tell the general or the admiral, hey, go to Guam and save the Chamorro, okay?
No.
Or even the president. I want you to secure Guam. We want to bomb the hell out of Japan. Okay?
Like in history books, it shows.
Just like that commanding officer on a ship, when one of our Chamorro swam across a boat ship, to more or less warn them that the great concentration of Chamorro population are here. He turned around and told this Chamorro swimmer, they're trying to get some help, showing them that don't bomb them or don't concentrate your canyon.
Over here
on this area, because this is where the Chamorro is. He turned and told this Chamorro, he said, my order is to blow up Guam, not to save Chamorro.
That's what, and that was a Chamorro person swimming out to a Navy vessel.
Right.
Talking to a commander asking, do not bomb Menengan.
Right. And but he returned his reply to the Chamorro swimmer. I'm not here to save Chamorro. I'm here to blow up Guam. So if he could say that, a commanding officer aboard ship could say that, imagine what the others...
They're saying thousands of miles away.
Huh? Or the other ships that are anchored out there waiting for destruction?
Yep. Launch.